joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands, and come before his presence with singing, with gladness, with thanksgiving. That's what we're doing today. Welcome, you're on Cleansing Fire. I am your pastor, Reverend Nicole Balasingh-Holder. We're so glad you joined us today as we move into worship and the Word. Spend this time with us as we grow closer to our Heavenly Father and make his name great in all the earth. So come on, join with us as we worship.
Take joy, my King, in what you have. Let it be a sweet, sweet sound. There's a healer in the house. There's a healer in this house. And I don't know who you trust in for your healing, but there's a healer. There's a healer in the house. If you believe it, lift your hands and say, there's a healer in this house. And I don't know who you trusted for your healing, but there's a healer. I'm bought with a price by his blood. to thy service, Lord. By thy power of grace divine, let my soul look up with a steadfast faith. God, and my will, my desire, my appetite, my will be lost in the
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Father, we worship you and we magnify your name. We give you all the praise, the honor, and the glory. Thank you, Lord, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together. And Father, as we lift up your name today, our hearts are ready. Our hearts are open to hear a word from you today. Oh God, pour out your spirit upon us. Pour out your spirit, oh God, on every waiting soul. And Father, let it fall on good ground. As Lord, we absorb your presence, your might and your power. Bless and anoint this word in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. God bless you again. Thank you for being with us here on Cleansing Fire. And we just came to lift up Jesus. We just came to give him praise. Today I want to take my text from 1 Kings chapter 17, verses 1 to 9. Now Elijah the Tishbite of Tishbe in Gilead said to Ahab the king, "As the Lord, the God of Israel, lives, before whom I stand, there shall be neither dew nor rain these years, except by my word." And the word of the Lord came to him, "Depart from here and turn eastward, and hide yourself by the brook Cherith, which is east of Jordan. You shall drink from the brook, and I have commanded the ravens to feed you there." So he went and did according to the word of the Lord. He went and lived by the brook Cherith, that is east of Jordan. And the ravens brought him bread and meat in the morning, and bread and meat in the evening. And he drank from that brook. And after a while, the brook dried up because there was no rain in the land. Today, I want to talk to you about the time at the brook. Right now, we are experiencing a situation that we have never experienced before. And in the walk of a believer, there is a varied display of situations that we would go through. Some are pleasant, some are tedious, some are character building, Some are downright dangerous. But here we see Elijah making his debut appearance as God's prophet to one of Israel's worst kings. And God always perfectly matches the prophets for the kings who reigned. Elijah was the one who was fit to deal with the daring sinners of that age that he lived in. And so wonderfully does God suit men to the work that he designs them for. Rough spirits are called to rough service. We are living in difficult times, and we need to see believers and leaders arise who would suit these times, who would speak the truth of God and bring God's perspective for these times. His first prophecy, Elijah's first prophecy, issued a famine in the land for 3.5 years. This was God's response to the nation's disobedience and rebellion against God, and it was led by a godless king. Then God instructed Elijah, after he gave that sound word, to head to a brook at Kerith Ravine, where he was kept for a time during God's judgment. And this brook offered exactly what Elijah needed for that time. And it gave him the protection, the provision, and the preparation during that time, so for the next level of his ministry. Many times we must be brought to the brook in order to arise stronger and to live worthy of the call that is upon our lives. I believe very much that we are at a time, and that time is at the brook. You see, at the brook, God protects his own. He protects his servants. He protects those who are given wholly over to him. From the king and the people. Who did he protect them from? The king and the people. You see, at the declaration of this word, that king would have wanted to sort out Elijah. He probably wanted to persuade him to recede and rescind from what he said, or intercede to God on behalf of the nation. Romans 1:18-20. The wrath of God is being revealed from heaven against all the godlessness and wickedness of the people who suppress the truth by their wickedness. Since what may be known about God is plain to them, because God has made it plain to them. For since the creation of the world, God's invisible qualities, his eternal power and divine nature, have been clearly seen and being understood from what has been made, so that people are without excuse. This word of judgment, this word came to this nation probably after many other words of warning, many other words that the king or the nation did not heed. And God said, this was the time to speak it forth. It's famine time. And the only way it is going to stop is by the word of the prophet that spoke it. That's why God had to hide his prophet. That's why God had to hide his servant, because somebody was going to try to persuade him to speak otherwise, to stop the famine otherwise. But the wages of sin will always be death. The consequence of disobedience and rebelliousness to God, you've got to go through the consequence. You've got to go through it, especially if you are not heeding the warning of God. This time at the brook, was a place of protection for him, where no one could have found him, where no one, if they found him, they would have tried to manipulate him. They would have tried to torture him. They would have tried to oppress and force him to do what against what God wanted to happen in that time. So God had to hide his own. I don't know who I'm talking to today, but in this time that we're living in, God is hiding some people. God is hiding his own. Some of us are sitting back and say, how come I'm not hearing from this one? How come I'm not hearing from that one? How come? God is hiding them. God is hiding them because God knows his servants. We are, so many of us are like Moses. We'll feel sorry. We will ask God to turn his hand. True servants of God understand that when God moves, the glory should be his and his alone. When it is time for God to move, we, not even the servants of God, must get in the way. I know we walk in mercy. I know we walk in compassion, but there are just some things that God has to do and God has to manifest. Psalm 46:10 says, be still and know that I am God, and I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. There are too many of us, too many people, too many believers that have taken the glory of God, that has distracted from the glory of God, that has taken things that don't belong to them and it belongs to God. And sometimes God has got to just move people out of the way, out of the vision, out of the focus. But God had to protect his prophet. He had to protect his leader. He had to protect his servants. I know some of you are becoming frustrated. I know some of you are becoming concerned. But this is your time at the brook. God, he is protecting you from some stuff. God, he's protecting you from hearing the wrong thing. God, listen to me, is protecting you from being influenced, my God, against his will. God sometimes have to protect his servant from the people. Servants of God need to be hidden. When God hides his servants, that means they've said all that they needed to say. Sometimes we can't say anything more. We cannot do anything more. We cannot minister anymore. Sometimes God has to hide us in order to come to his people for himself. I want somebody to know that in this particular time, we are seeing God moving people who have depended on leaders and depended on prayer warriors and depended on strong people in their family. God has hidden them away from you because he wants to deal with you personally. There are some things that we need to learn. There are some things that we need to face God with for ourselves. God is dealing with nations in this time, my God, so nobody will be confused. Who had to speak? Who had the time to speak the real word of God? Who had the time to warn the people of God? That time is quickly coming to an end, and it has passed for some. So God has moved us out of the way. Servants of God, pastors and leaders, know when it is time to end. Know where God has you. At this brook, my God, he didn't need to preach a sermon. He didn't need to have a crowd. That time was past. When you do what God has called you to do according to his will, when the time of silence comes, when the time of quietness comes, your heart will not be heavy. Because you know you did and you said and you operated in the way that God has called you to operate. Your time at the brook is a time of protection. My God, I want you to know, it's not that your pastor is not faithful. It's not that the leaders are not there for you. But God wants you, child of God, to trust him. He wants you to build personal relationship with him. He wants to take the training wheels off of your life, all of the support systems that you have managed to set up in your life. He wants to nurture you to maturity. My God, you had the chance Sunday after Sunday and you gleaned nothing from the word of God. But God is saying you have heard enough messages. You've been under enough ministry. You've been released to enough anointings for you to begin to grow, for you to begin to carry the responsibility of your own salvation, to work it out in fear and in trembling. It's time for the people of God to face their God. It's time for the true believer to begin to mature in the goodness of God. Ah, your time at the brook must be a time of maturity. It must be a time as God is protecting you from the forces of the world, from the storms of this world, from the conspiracies of this world. You need to be in a place of silence. You need to be in a place where you can hear from God. Your time at the brook, it is protecting you from the assault of the enemy. It is protecting you from compromising your faith. It is protecting you from being influenced by the workers of iniquity. Take this time at the brook and enjoy your protection. For the Lord says, when I see the blood, that I will pass over you. That time at the brook, it not only protects, but it provides. Our provision is constant. In the midst of the famine, Elijah enjoyed meals at the right time of the day, and he enjoyed water. When nobody could get food, when water was scarce, here God, in the midst of it, is providing for his own. I want you to know, now is not the time to complain and cry, but if you're standing in the place quietly and obediently where God has taken you, you will thrive. You will prosper. You will have need of nothing, because God will never send you into a space where you are going to have to beg. I will not suffer. I will not beg for food. Ah, the psalmist said, I have never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. If you're in the right place, even in the worst of circumstances, I want you to know when trouble comes, my God has a place for you. My God has a provision for you. My God is a refuge and a present help in the time of trouble. You will not go without a meal. You will not live in scarcity. So where God has you, we've got to believe this time at the brook, he is going to provide. He's already provided. Oh, whatever you ask in Jesus' name, present it before him, because he's already provided. He's already made the way. For some of us, our provision will come from the most unlikely sources. The ravens were considered unclean, but what they dropped for Elijah was good enough for him to eat, was good enough to sustain him, was good enough to keep him healthy and to keep him through, while people were dropping like flies because of scarcity plenty of bread. Here this man of God was being fed, and being fed by something that was tabooed as dirty, something that was tabooed, my God, as unlikely. But I want you to know that this is a miracle time for somebody. God has you in that place, and I decree and declare to you, his provision is going to come. Don't question the provision. Don't question the protection. Ah, my God, it may come from a place that you're not expecting. It's coming from a person that, my God, you would not have looked at twice. But that's how God will work. Proverbs 23:22, the wealth of the sinner is laid up for the righteous. Psalm 34:10, the lions may grow weak and hungry, but those who seek the Lord will lack no good thing. 2 Corinthians 9:10, and God is able to make all grace abound to you, so that having all sufficiency in all things and in at all times, you may abound in every good work. Listen to me, curfew or quarantine or pandemic, God is able to make all grace abound to you. He's got you in that place because he's already provided. He's already furnished you. My God, he's already set a table before you, even in the presence of your enemies. Take this time at the brook, my God, drink in of the water, the springs of living water. Eat on the bread of life. Oh, you will not be thirsty. You will not be hungry, physically or spiritually. God is filling you at this time. God is providing for you at this time. God is giving you testimony at this time at the brook. Ah, take your time. Though the world is going crazy around you, you will not suffer. You will not be in need, for the promises of God are yea and amen. And he has given you all sufficiency in everything that you need at all times, even in the bad times, even in the sad times, even in the times of lack. You will have all sufficiency given to you, because that is the power, that is the purpose, that is the provision of the child of God. Somebody shout, thank you, Lord. At the brook, God will prepare us. He will protect you. There are some of you, you don't know why things are going, but God has protected you from some stuff. And if you look back over this time, you never went without a meal, unless you decided to fast and pray that day. But God provided everything. The problem is, many of us try to live beyond our means. So that is where we will feel the pinch. But God says, don't worry about the luxury. I will always give you more than enough. And we need to have and be content, because God is taking care of us. And he's also preparing us. God, what is happening in this time? We are seeing fourth and fifth and sixth waves. We go out for a month, we go out for 2 weeks, and then we're locked back down again, and different things are happening. But have you noticed that God is trying to prepare us? 1 Kings 17:7, sometime later, the brook dried up because there had been no rain in the land. You see, this brook was not it was a temporal place. It was a resting place. I want you to know that this time, take full use of this time. This is your resting place. This is your fueling station. You were not meant to set up shop here. You were not meant to build cathedrals here. and build altars here. This is just a temporal place. The place that God will mature your faith for daily provision. You see, he didn't have to worry. In faith, God said it and he believed it. Before he even got to the place, God told him how he will provide for him. And he did. So his faith, when he got up every morning, was not to ask God for anything. But his faith, what caused him to thank God in advance. Thank God for the meal he was about to receive. Thank God that God provided even the raven, which was considered the dirtiest bird to bring. And his faith consecrated that meal. His faith did not see, my God, the dirtiness of the bird, but his faith saw the provision of his God. This was the place where he had to communicate and trust God alone. There was nobody else, nobody to talk to, nobody to communicate with. A lot of people have been locked up on their own, void of company, void of some communication. Ah, but God is saying, I need to quiet your atmosphere. I need to get through to talk to somebody. And he put his trust in God. This was the place where God prepared him for the next season of his ministry. When you read about the ministry of Elijah, it was a ministry of miracles. It was a ministry of manifestation and demonstration of God's ultimate power. And in order for us to carry about that and to demonstrate God's power in the earth, we got to spend time with God. We've got to glean from God. We've got to walk with God. We've got to prepare our mental, our physical, our spiritual, our psychological. Everything that makes up our lives need to be in total alignment for the next level for God. Ah, God is saying when the ministry begins to flow, I can't afford for your body to fall flat. When ministry for the next level begins to flow, we can't afford to become depressed and to become lonely. Ah, when ministry to the next level comes, we won't have time to look at the past and analyze the past and have it affect our present. He said, I'm giving you the time to work it out between you and I. I'm giving you the time to let the Holy Spirit begin to prune and to begin to trim and to begin to cut. In the midst of ministry, in the next level, we cannot stumble, we cannot fall because we didn't take care of our weaknesses, of our fleshly desires. This is the time to mortify the deeds of the flesh. This is the time to discipline ourselves. This is the time to yield ourselves wholly to God. Because when you are faithful to God and there is spiritual famine, God will create distance between you and the present apostasy. Listen to me. There is an apostate spirit that is flooding through the earth. Ah, but God, if the time of the brook, if you have taken that time, he's going to shield you. He's going to cover you. Many people will not agree with you. Many people might have other ideas and think you should be doing something else. Ah, but the word of God is saying, stand still and see the salvation of your God. Sometimes we get so involved, we think nothing can happen if we are not in it, if our hand is not in it. But God is saying, pull off your hand. I'm about to deal. I'm about to move. I am God all by myself. And at this time, at the brook, our God is preparing us to bring in the sheaves. God is preparing us for a brand new outreach. God is preparing us for a last harvest. God is preparing us with the thoughts and with the words and with the demonstration and with the power to bring in those lost souls. Are you taking that time? Are you making use of that time at the brook? God prepares us. Because I want you to know that some miracles have an expiration date. What are you saying, Rev? That's exactly what I'm saying. Because when the time had come, the brook dried up. And that was the man of God's signal to move. That miracle was a miracle to sustain him for the season. The miracles that you're seeing, it's for this season. Don't settle down in it. Don't get comfortable with it. Again, it is a temporal place. It is a resting place. But the expiry date is coming on it soon. And when it comes to an end, that means God has another place prepared. When the brook dries up, it's time to move. When things are opened up, it's time to move, not business as usual. Not talking like you used to talk. Not behaving like the world. But we've got to come and stand with more holiness. Stand with more fire and operate in the righteousness of God. The brook is drying up and it's time to move. Will you be ready? Will you be ready to move? When the brook dries up, it's time for the next level. Are you ready for the next level? Are you prepared to bring in the harvest? Are you prepared to be a witness for the Lord Jesus Christ? It's not just about you, but it's what you should be doing at this time. Maybe before this season, you weren't doing what you're supposed to do. You were involved in things, but you had the wrong agenda. But you were moving with a different mindset. At this time, allow God to minister to you. Allow His holy anointing to break every chain, to break every yoke, to break every weakness, to break every bad habit in your life. Because it's time for next level. Not the next level where you can gain all the prosperity and all the wealth, but it's a next level of outreach. It's a next level of compassion. It's a next level of the Great Commission to go into all the world. I preach this week after week, service after service, because your job is not just to be educated in your mind, but the word of God must sting you and must slit your conscience to know that it's time to get up, to know that there is a challenge to be met. If you're listening to the word of God and you're not feeling challenged in your spirit, you're not feeling revived to do the work of God, then something is wrong. Every word that God is allowing you to hear, every ministry He's allowing you to sit under, it is to challenge you, to challenge you to reach out, to challenge you to your next level of excellence, your next level of ability, your next level, my God, of doing what you can. When the brook dries up, it's time to transition into God's new season. This season is far spent. This season is about to come to a close. But in this season, God has shown mercy to His people. God has shown grace to His remnant church. But this season, the brook is about to dry up. And this season is about to launch out a chosen generation. Hey, this season is about to raise up a powerful people. The Bible says in Joel, they will rise, my God, like a mighty army. They will have a sound that will thunder in the earth. They will have a message that will split the heavens wide open. It's a remnant and an army of people that are coming with the sound of war to take back, my God, what the enemy has taken, to run in into the gates of hell and break it down and tear it asunder and grab the souls. Grab the souls. It's a mighty army. Are you ready for the next season? Or are you still wondering about money and wondering about houses and land and wondering about family? Now is the time. Now is the accepted time. The brook is drying up. Child of God, like a mighty army, moves the church of God. Brothers, we are treading where the saints have trod. Now is not the time for division. Now is not the time for divisiveness. Now is not the time for one to feel better than the other or to exalt themselves higher than the other. Now is the time to move. Move as one. Move with God's agenda. Move with God's heart. Move in God's will. Now is the accepted time to move right now in the purity of the anointing. No more imitations. No more divisiveness. No more thus saith the Lord when the Lord ain't saying anything. Listen to me. Ah, my God. I read from one apostle that one word that was spoken to Noah, that was the word that saw him through. It was the word that helped him to build the ark. It was the word that allowed him to preach for 120 years. It was the word that kept him through the floods 40 days and 40 nights. It was that word that kept him until he stood on solid ground to give God the praise again. All you need is one word. At this time at the brook, get your word. Be empowered by that word. Be persuaded by that word. So God can raise you up. And that's the word that will take you to your next level. That's the word. My God, you don't have to question. When Elijah got the direction from God, my God, that provision was already there. That instruction was already there. The people ahead of him already aligned to the will of God. Ah, who am I talking to? It's time to walk in the spirit. It's and not gratify the deeds of the flesh. It's time to come up higher. It's time to worship higher. It's time to serve God on a higher plane. The brook is drying up. Ah, this miracle is coming to an end. It's time to move forward. It's time to move forward for the last and the closing. This is it. Don't get taken up. Don't worry about the mark of the beast. Don't worry about the world system. You are covered. You are redeemed. You are called forth. You are a holy nation. Ah, it's time to act like it. It's time to go forth like it, because the world must see the best of God's kingdom. The world must see the power of God's people, where there is no compromise, where there is no deadness, where there is no perversion, where there is no corruption, the real church of God. Will you stand up in this next season? The brook is drying up. The brook is drying up. You're going back to church, and the church is not going to be at full capacity. Ah, who will go out and fill it back up again? God is bringing us back to what is important to him, and what is important to him is his souls for the kingdom, the souls of men, to persuade them, to compel them, and to bring them into the ark of safety. What are you doing at the time of the brook? This is your time at the brook. This is your time where God is protecting you from others, protecting you from things, to hear things, protecting you from death, protecting you from disease. And he's also providing. We have seen the hand of God. And all we're coming out of this season with is a thank you, Jesus. How can I say thanks for the things you've done for me? It's more than my tongue can tell. And oh, this is the time where God is strengthening. Ah, God is enlarging our course. The burden is becoming even heavier to be the oracles of God in this season. Ah, don't hold on to this miracle. It's coming to an end because a bigger miracle is in store. A bigger breakthrough is in store. A bigger harvest is waiting for the children of God. Heavenly Father. Oh God, reach your children. God, I speak your challenge. I speak your challenge. May we not hear this word and go back and do the same thing. Wake us up. Ah, God, build us up in our most holy places. Let us be, my God, the shepherds of our homes. Oh God, may we be the mouthpieces. In this day and in this time, let the power begin to flow, even now, even now. Oh God, I pray that your people catch the vision. Ah God, you will clean out their eyes and show them in the spirit. Show them your heart. Show them your perspective. Show them what is most important to you, oh God. Father, save to the uttermost. Heal to the uttermost. Those on beds of affliction, oh God, like the thief on the cross, although they knew eternity was at hand, let them cry out. Let them make sure that their salvation is worked out. Let them have relationship with you in the name of Jesus. Oh God, continue to, Lord, fashion us with boldness. Empower us with a new anointing, a new anointing. As we come out roaring for the glory of God. For those of you who don't know this Jesus, you have wasted enough time. You have gone after the things of the world. But at the end of the day, people in this pandemic will tell you, on that bed of affliction, they had to face their creator and they had to make it right. I am God has blessed you that maybe some of you haven't gotten to that point. So my urgent message to you is give your life to Jesus today. He will heal your mind. He will heal your body. He will take care of your circumstance. He will never put you in a place where he will not furnish you and provide for you. Oh, put your hand on your heart and say, my heavenly Father, forgive me. Wash me in your blood as I turn from darkness to light, as I reject the world and I embrace you. Save me, Lord Jesus, and I thank you in your name, Jesus. Amen and amen. Come on, give God the glory. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I feel the anointing. I feel the anointing. I decree and declare that at this time of the brook, before the brook dries up, you will receive your instruction for the next level. I decree and declare to somebody today, as the brook will dry up, that my God, you will be prepared. I declare powerful anointings to arise, unique and exclusive anointings. Oh God, submissive ministries, humble people to come forth in the name of Jesus. Oh God, at this time at the brook, I decree and declare to somebody, you will not be a grumbler anymore. You will not be negative anymore. You will not be a heaviness and a load to anybody else anymore. You will not be, my God, the problem. But I decree and declare you coming out of this time, being the help, being the assistance, being a leader in the kingdom of God, to bring forth solutions, to bring forth answers in the name of Jesus. I call you forth. I call you forth to rise up out of this hour, not being intimidated. limited, not being ashamed, not being oppressed, but being strong, being mighty. Oh God, I declare that He will anoint your lips right now, that you will roar like the Lion of Judah that lives inside of you. Oh, begin to receive the word of the Lord in this season, in this moment, for the brook is getting ready to dry up. Are you ready? Are you armored up? Are you in tune with God for what He's about to do? God, give us eyes of faith. God, may we see the vision and run with it. As we bring your people forth, we bring them forth refined. We bring them forth well pruned and trimmed and ready for the Master's use. And Father, we give you praise. Come on, lift those hands. I feel the anointing. Oh, let a new anointing rest upon you. Let a new power come upon you right now, right now, right now. In the name of Jesus. That's why the enemy is fighting you in your body. Because when God is ready for the next level, you don't have time for that. So I declare perfect healing now. Perfect cleansing now. I command the deliverance of God to loose every chain and every fetter. In the name of Jesus. God, you're setting your people free. And we're ready, we're ready. Somebody say, shout, shout. Lord, I am ready. Lord, I am ready. In the name of Jesus, receive all that He has in this time. For the time is coming, a time of power. Ah, to meet and to face our King in all of His glory. Hallelujah. Come on, give God a good round of applause. Rabe anda la ba kore bebebe sakaba yanda la basu. Rete anda la ba ba basa. Your children will not be hungry, my God. Your family will not be touched. And even if they've come through this fire, and my God, you've come through this pandemic, I decree and declare you're coming stronger, you're coming mightier, you're coming seeing clearer, you're coming speaking in boldness. Oh God, oh God, oh God. Hallelujah. Let that prophetic unction and that prophetic word cling and grab you in your spirit right now. I feel it all over me. I feel it all over me. That word that is going to take you through to your next season. Let it be done. Let it be done. You don't have to get 5 and 6 and 7 words. My God, that's familiar spirits. But God has given a word. God has given unction. I feel the unction to function. Right now, in the name of Jesus, receive it, receive it, receive it. Somebody is receiving it right now. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to the Most High God. Thank you, Lord. Oh, just bask in His presence right now. I feel His presence. Salabako rebebe yandalabasa. Oh, shout to the Lord, all the earth. Ah, let us sing with gladness. Our God is in the temple. Your God is in this space. Your God is in this moment. The Spirit of the Lord is upon us. And He's dispensing anointings right now, right now, right now. Receive this word in might and power in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 Jesus. Ooh, what an anointing. I feel the presence of God. It's hard to stop. It's hard to stop. But you just continue in worship. You just continue in glory. Continue in the magnificent presence of the Holy Spirit. Oh, I am Reverend Nicole Balasingholder. And it was fantastic being with you. Ah, my God, I feel this word. It's going to vibrate. It's going to vibrate in you throughout the season to take you into the next. And trust God for it. Rise up and know that He is God. Hallelujah. Just for this week only, we want you to know that Prayer Point will be on Friday night at 8 o'clock. Just for this week only. So please join us on Friday night as we pray the kingdom into the earth, right? And join with us, because there's power in that agreement. On behalf of all of us, here at Cleansing Fire have a powerful, prepared, purposed, and just a ready spirit for the next level. And spend your time at the brook in victory. God bless you. We love you.